the PolyMet Mining Corporation has proposed the development of an open pit copper and nickel mine with processing and support facilities in northern Minnesota. Called NorthMet Mining, the proposed mine would be located about 6 miles south of Babbitt on Superior National Forest land and on property owned or leased by PolyMet. The proposed plant site would use the former LTV mining facilities near Hoyt Lakes. The plant site would be in the watershed of Embarrass River. The mine site would be in the Partridge River's watershed. Both sites would be in the larger watershed of the St. Louis River, which flows to Lake Superior. These watersheds do not flow north to the Boundary Waters Canoe area. The NorthMet mining proposal consists of three main components: the mine, the plant site, and a utility corridor connecting the two locations. The NorthMet mining project proposes to extract copper, nickel, cobalt, and precious metals such as platinum and palladium for 20 years. Three mine pits, east, central, and west, would be operated over that time. The east and west pits would be mined simultaneously for the first 11 years. After the 11th year, mining would stop in the east pit and would start in the central pit. The central pit would be mined until the 16th year, by which time it would have merged with the east pit to form one pit. The west pit would be mined during all 20 years. Sulfur-containing minerals called sulfides occur in the rock formation at the proposed mining site. These sulfur compounds oxidize or break down when they are exposed to air and water. When oxidized, the rocks can release various dissolved substances, such as sulfate and metals, into the water, which could cause surface water and groundwater contamination and damage to the ecosystem. The NorthMet mining project proposes a plan to prevent pollution from sulfides oxidizing. To begin, the waste rock would be categorized by its sulfur content. Category 1 would have the lowest sulfur content, while Category 4 would have the highest. Category 1 waste rock would be stockpiled near the west pit with a containment system to collect runoff from rain and melting snow that came in contact with the rock. Waste rock in categories 2, 3, and 4 would be stockpiled next to the mine pits on liners to capture and treat runoff water. After the 11th year, when mining would stop in the east pit, the stockpiled waste rock in categories 2, 3, and 4 would be backfilled into the east pit. Categories 2, 3, and 4 waste rock mined after the 11th year would be put directly into the east pit. Then the merged east and central pit would be flooded after being backfilled with waste rock. An ore surge pile would be a temporary stockpile on the mine site. Any runoff water from the surge pile would also be collected and treated. After mining ended at the west pit, it too would be flooded and a pit lake would be created. PolyMet Mining owns the mineral rights to the proposed NorthMet site, but not the land, which is part of the Superior National Forest. Portions of the proposed mine site are forested land featuring a variety of tree species and plant life. Other parts of the site are covered with a large wetland area and smaller wetlands and streams. The site also is habitat for numerous birds and mammals. The company has offered to exchange a pool of private lands for the 6,650 acres of Forest Service land at the NorthMet site. This swap of federal and private lands must be consistent with the forest plan for the Superior National Forest. Also, the value of the private lands must equal the appraised value of the federal lands. The final decision on the proposal will consider if the land exchange serves the public's interest and meets the direction of the forest plan. The NorthMet mining proposal would reopen the LTV Steel Mining Company's former taconite processing facility near Hoyt Lakes. This industrial site would be upgraded to crush and concentrate ore mined from the nearby mine site. Existing rock crushing equipment would be modified and upgraded for the new operation. The proposed hydrometallurgical plant would be an autoclave to heat and oxidize the crushed ore in order to collect the valuable metals. Tailings from the ore processing would be placed within the existing LTV iron ore tailings basin at the plant site. Runoff from the new tailings would be controlled by a containment system and a wastewater treatment plant. This treatment plant would also treat processing water for the plant and water piped from the mine site. The proposed NorthMet mining project would also include a 7-mile utility corridor between the mine site and the plant site. This corridor would use existing road, railroad track, and electrical lines. The railroad line would transport the ore from the mine to the processing plant. The roadway would carry machines and supplies to and from the mine site. Electrical lines would provide power to the mine site and the plant site. A new pipeline would be added to the corridor to carry water pumped from the mine site to the processing plant, where it would be used as process water. Wastewater management is included in the NorthMet mining proposal to capture and treat water that might become contaminated during the operation of the mine or the processing plant. Collection systems would capture runoff water that comes in contact with the waste rock stockpiles and the ore surge pile next to the mine. A wastewater treatment facility at the mine would treat this water. Water pumped out of the mine pits would be used in processing ore at the plant. This and any other processing water would be collected along with the water seepage from the tailings basin at the plant site. A second wastewater treatment plant would treat all of this water at the plant site. The wastewater treatment is expected to be operated on a long-term basis. Testing of wastewater treatment plant effectiveness is an ongoing effort by PolyMet. Reclaiming of the mine site would begin while it was operating. After mining progresses from the east pit to the central pit, the east pit would be backfilled with waste rock. The stockpile of Category 1 waste rock would be covered with an engineered geomembrane cover beginning in the 14th year of mining. After the east and central pits have been flooded to cover the waste rock and to limit the oxidation of sulfides, a wetland would be constructed over the backfilled rock. Storing the waste rock underwater would reduce the environmental effects from the oxidation of sulfides. The NorthMet mining project would have financial assurance in place prior to any mining activity. The amount of the financial assurance would be reviewed and adjusted as needed on an annual basis. This would assure the site would be properly closed and would maintain environmental protections after the mining site and plant site had ceased operating.